Students, in the exercise 3.1, already you have studied first and second main questions. Today, we solve the third question. Find the mean of the first five whole numbers. To find the mean of first five whole numbers, first five whole numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Answer. First five whole numbers equals to 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Therefore, mean equals to, the formula to find the mean is sum of all observations divided by number of observations. These are the observations. Take their sum. Sum of all observations divided by number of observations. That is equals to sum of all observations 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 divided by number of observations. Count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's equals to, take the sum of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 plus, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 3 is 6, 6 plus 4 is 10. 10 divided by 5, that's equals to, now cut by 5, 5 1s are, 5 2s are, that's equals to 2. Question number 4. In the question number 4, a cricketer scores the following runs in 8 innings. 58, 76, 40, 35, 46, 50, 45, 0, 100. Find the mean score. In this question, the given scores are
58, 76, 40, 35, 46, 45, 0 and 100.
And number of innings. Number of innings is equals to 8. Therefore, mean is equals to sum of all the scores. Sum of all the scores divided by number of innings. That's equals to sum of all the scores. Take the sum of all these numbers. That's equals to 58 plus 76 plus 40 plus 35 plus 46 plus 45 plus 0 plus 100 whole thing divided by number of innings. Total number of innings is 8. That is equals to, now sum of all these scores, by adding all these numbers we get 400. It is the sum of all scores, 400 divided by 8. Now cut by 8. 8 ones are, 8 fives are 40, then put on 0. That is equals to 50. This is the mean score. Therefore, mean score is equals to 50. Next question number 5. In the question number 5, following table shows the points of each player scored in 5 games. One column players, another column game 1, game 2, game 3, game 4. Players A, B, C.
player A, B, C. Game 1, game 2, game 3, game 4. Player A, in game 1, the score is 14, game 2, 16, game 3, 10, game 4, 10. Player B scores 0, 8, 6 and 4. Next, player C scores 8 point in game 1. 11 point in second game, and he did not play the third game. And 13 points in fourth game. Now answer the following questions. First question, find the mean to determine A's average number of points scored per game. Here, player A played all the four games. So, mean of player A. Mean of player A is equal to sum of all the scores 14 plus 16 plus 10 plus 10 is equal to sum of all points divided by sum of all points or all scores divided by number of games played by player A. That is equal to sum of all the points of player A, 14 plus 16 plus 10 plus 10 divided by number of games. Player A played all the four games. Number of games is 4. That is equal to take the sum of 14, 16, 10 and 10. 0, 0, 6 plus 4 is 10. 1 carry. 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 1, 5, divided by 4. By dividing 50 by 4, its answer is 12 whole 2 by 4. 12 whole 2 by 4, that's equals to, now this is improper fraction, converting to the mixed fraction, 12 whole 2 by 4, cut 2 1s are, 2 2s are, that's equals to, 12 whole 1 by 2, that is equals to 12.5. This is the mean score of player A. Second question. In the second question, to find the mean number of points per game for C, would you divide the total points by 3 or by 4 and 5? So, according to this table, to find the main points of player B played all 4 games, whereas player C played only 3 games. First game, second game, and fourth game, but the player C did not play game 3. So to find the mean points of player C, we divide the sum of all the points by 3, because the number of games played by player C is only 3. Therefore, we will divide the sum of all points by 3. Player C played 3 games only. Therefore, to find the mean points of player C, we divide total points. We divide total points by 3. In the same question, sub question number 3, B played in all the 4 games. How would you find the mean? Player B played all the 4 games. To find the mean of player B, divide the total points by 3. Therefore, we find mean point of player B by dividing sum of all scores by 4. By dividing sum of all scores by 4, we will get the mean of player B. Question number 4. Who is the best performer? To find who is the best performer in this question, find out the mean of all the 3 players, player A, player B, player C. Now, already the mean of player A is found in first question, it is 12.5. Now, similarly, find the mean of B and C. Already mean of player A is found in the first question, it is 12.5. Next, mean of player B is equals to sum of all the points divided by number of games, that is equals to 0 plus 8 plus 6 plus 4. 0 plus 8, 0 plus 8 plus 6 plus 4 divided by total number of games is 4, that is equals to, by adding 0, 8, 6 and 4, their sum is 18. 6 plus 4 is 10, 10 plus 8 is 18, 18 plus 0 is 18 divided by 4, that is equals to 4 4s are 16. See here, 4 4s are 16, remaining 2, 2 by 4, that is equals to 4.5. 4 4s are 16, 18 by 4 is improper fraction, converting to mixed fraction it is 4 whole, 2 by 4, then 2 1s are, 2 2s are, it is 4 whole 1 by 2, 4 whole 1 by 2 is nothing but 4.5. And similarly, number C, to find the mean of player C, mean of player C is equals to sum of all the scores, 8 plus 11 plus 13, 8 plus 11 plus 13 divided by 3, that is equals to, now 8 plus 1 is 9, 9 plus 3 is 12, 1 carry, 1 plus 1 2, 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 by 32 divided by 3, that is equals to, now 3 tens are 30, 3 tens are 30, point, then it is 2 by 3, 3 tens are 30, remaining 2, 2 by 3, that is equals to, now dividing 2 by 3, or 32 by directly, 32 by 3, 3 ones are 3, 3 3 cancel, then take 2, not possible to divide, put 0 in the quotient, next put the decimal point, take 1 0, 3 6 the 18, now the value is 10.6, that is equals to 10.6. So by comparing the mean of player A, B and C, the mean of player A is 12.5. This is greater than player B and player C. Therefore, the performance, the best performer is player A. Therefore, comparing mean of player A, B and C, mean of A is greater than mean of player A, player B and player C. Therefore, our question is to find who is the best performer. Therefore, player A is the best performer. Question number 6. The marks out of 100 obtained by a group of students in a science test are 85, 76, 90, 85, 39, 48, 56, 95, 81 and 75. Find number 1, highest and the lowest marks obtained by the student. Second question, range of the marks obtained. Third question, mean marks obtained by the student. Now in this question, we are given the marks obtained by the group of students. Marks obtained by group of students. It is given 85, 76, 90, 85, 39, 48, 56, 95, 81 and 75. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, first question is, these are the observations. These marks are the observations in the question. First question is, highest and the lowest marks obtained by the student. In the given observation, find which is the highest observation. 85, 76, 90, 85, 39, 48, 56, 95, 81 and 75. Out of all these observations, 95 is the highest. So, it is the highest marks. And similarly, find the lowest marks, 39. 39 is the lowest. This is highest. And this is the lowest. Therefore, our question is, first find highest and the lowest marks obtained by the students. Therefore, highest marks is equals to how much it is? 95. And lowest marks is equals to 39. This is first question. Second question, range of the marks obtained. Second one, range of marks. Students, already you have studied how to find the range. Range is obtained by subtracting the lowest score from the highest score. Therefore, range of marks is equal to highest marks, highest marks minus lowest marks, that is equal to highest marks is 95 minus lowest marks is 39. 95 minus 39. 5 minus 9 is not possible, take one carry. 15 minus 9 is 6. Then 9 minus 4 is 5. 56 is the range of the marks. In the question number 6, sub question number 3, we need to find mean marks obtained by the group. To find the mean marks obtained by the group, take the sum of all observations and divide by the number of students. So mean equals to, mean equals to sum of all observations divided by number of observations. That is equals to sum of all observations, 85 plus 76 plus 90 plus 85 plus 39 plus 48 plus 56 plus 95 plus 81 plus 75, whole thing divided by number of observations, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That is equals to sum of all these observations is 730. Then divided by 10, cancel 1 zeros. That is equals to 73. This is the mean marks obtained by the group of students. Therefore, mean marks obtained by the group of students is 73. Okay, students, try to understand all these problems and practice them.